and welcome back to another LEGO Star Wars review. Today I got for you is the Imperial Landing Craft. And this thing came out clear back in the year 2007, so it's nearly 10 years old now. One thing I want to point out is, LEGO usually does remakes of sets. Like, we got a couple different X-Wings, couple different TIE Fighters, so on and so forth. While as this one has zero. This is the only one they've ever made so far, which makes it actually very special. And I do love the ship. Been trying to get it for years and finally got it. Enough of that, let's start with the minifigures. We get the TIE Fighter pilot, and it's amazing how the detailing and sculpt has come a long way since 2007. Each minifigure does have a black head. Then you get two Stormtroopers and two Sandtroopers. The other two are inside the ship itself. Sorry. And they're exactly the same, it's just one has a pauldron. Now, for the ship itself. The cockpit doesn't lift up. You actually have to take off this entire piece to gain access. And that is actually a printed brick. And the head does move, but it's just so it can lean down like that. Now, on each side of this thing, right here and here, you actually have these giant missiles. And you just press either one of these little green cones to make them fly out. I'll just go ahead and show you the one for now. Yeah. Oops, sorry, I didn't mean to bump the camera. But, yeah, it's one of those really big ones. And I actually like these a lot better than those little skinny ones or even the foot fire missiles that we used to get. On both sides, you can lift these up to gain access to the, I guess you can call it cargo hold that holds the troops. And there's that little piece right there, and if I push it, it just pulls, it goes back on the lever to make it fire. Then, these little pieces here. You get four, two on each side, and again on either side you have these little red pieces, and what you do is you push up and the bombs come flying out. Now usually I try to keep them out of the set because they don't really stay very well inside there. Just thought I'd mention that. And then we have the wings, which can go into flight mode. Very nice. Let's see if I can get back a little further. I actually do think the engines might be a little wrong. I think they're supposed to be separated like that. But other than that, but yes, then you can go back to landing mode. There we go. Then the landing gear are these two very large pieces, which I actually rather like. Then last but not least, these red pins, both on the front and the back. If I pull them both out, set it down like so, lift this entire piece off, and I've deployed the troops for their mission. Get a better view of this thing. But yes, you have two blue seats, and you can fit the troops in there. You can also fit another troop behind this cannon and the other one. You get some storage for some guns, like the two rifles, and also, kind of hard to see, right there. Right there, those two little regular blasters. Yes, there's that compartment for the little bombs. Now, when you're ready to come back and pick up the troops, you just put this thing back over, like so. Lock in the pins. And you're ready to go. Here is the packaging it came in. Also, mine, I ordered it and it came like this. I just thought I'd point that out, but hey, it's not in bad condition for nearly 10 years. The features it can do, and more sets you can buy, which I pretty much have them all except that little clone one. And that's all the time I have for this LEGO Star Wars review, guys. Until next time. Admiral, alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival.